¿Cómo estamos?
What a victory from Pedro Acosta. Dominant victory here in the Italian Grand Prix. It's a masterclass from your world championship leader. What a Grand Prix.
History has been.
Acosta's got it.
He's got it.
One of the biggest problems of my career that I arrived to the championship and I win my first year. This maybe was more a problem than a good thing. I never know what was to arrive to the championship, struggle, don't win races, then start to make an improve, make my first podium, then my first victory. Everything arrived so soon for a guy that was so young in these days, you know. I didn't know what was half a bad year. Then I arrived in 2022 in Moto2 and everything arrived. I mean, I miss a bit of grip, of feeling with bike. I start to crash a lot. Now I know what is half a bad year. I understand what is fight from the year before to achieve one target. With one more year of experience and these things, was easier to arrive to one track and say, okay, I have to do this and that to go fast. We used the same bike from last year, we don't change anything, and the team said to me, clear, man, this bike is ready to win. Now we have to manage our style, because sometimes I could be the wonder boy, or another day I could be the hell, you know, because I have the help and the angel in both shoulders, and sometimes the hell was more strong than the angel.
Congratulations, all hail 2023 Moto2 World Champion, it's Pedro Acosta. The Spanish superstar creates history. He is the youngest ever Moto2 World Champion.
Was a feeling that was quite familiar to me, you know, because it's something that don't happen every day. And for me, happened 2 times in 3 years.
He is your 2023 Moto2 World Champion, just the second rider to be crowned Moto3 and Moto2 champion.
I was much more calm fighting for the championship than in 2021, that maybe I was a kid and I don't really realize what was happening in my life. I really have to say that I enjoy more than the Moto3 one.
World Champion, eh, Ferrari? No sé cuándo me voy a poner otra vez, tío.
Te la aprovecho. Me ha emocionado.
¿Qué te voy a echar?
Me va a echar veneno. Yo también. Hoy no voy a llorar por respeto, ¿eh? Pero porque ayer lloré mucho, pero en Valencia seguramente lloré también.
I spent the best 3 years of my life in a young motorsport. Take me like a little son, you know, and I grow up with them, you know, and I understand the life in the way that I understand, because they give me advice to understand like this, you know. For this, I am living the dream of many people. For this, I have to be so happy. It's true that I am quite shy to leave the team, but for sure, these both lines are gonna arrive together one day.
So exciting times, because I think we've all been looking forward for a number of years to see Pedro Acosta on a MotoGP bike at last.
No expectation. At the end, if you have expectation, you have pressure. If you have pressure, you can make mistakes easily. If you make mistakes easily, you don't learn. If you don't learn, you don't improve. If you improve, you go home. It's true that this the jump with the big boys is the change of an old kid to a young man, you know. And I have a lot of things to learn before being competitive. For this, I will try to be calm, take time to learn, and when the moment to be competitive arrive, I will be.